Good morning. With this tutorial, I want to show you how to use the DMACSuite Continuous Wipe Proof of Improvement in the improvement phase of a DMAC project. First thing you have to know is that all the cells in this table in blue are protected. It means you cannot erase them. And in case there is a formula behind, you will see on the top bar the formula, but you cannot change it, of course. So this is the continuous Y or CTQ continuous of your project, proof of improvement. You have done improvements and you want to test that after your project, after your improvement, your performance is better than before. And for this, we will use simply boxplot. We will calculate some normality test here, basic statistics, like in measure phase, in fact, with before and after data. Before data can be the same as the measure phase, by the way, and after, it has to be collected after you have made improvements. So we will calculate box plot with upper spec limit, lower spec limit for before and after to see graphically is there a difference. And here you see the mean is below and the spread of data is different. It's very small here and it's wide here. So probably there is a big difference. So graphically, with two columns of data, one for before and one for after, we can see if there is, graphically speaking, a difference in mean, median, and also variation spread of your data. And it can be confirmed by test, statistical test. And this is the point here, below normality test of the two samples for before and after, you will find descriptive stats, like in measure, and process capability. And here, you will enter your lower spec limit and upper spec limit. If you have only lower spec limit, it's fine. You can just enter one specification limit, can be lower spec limit or upper spec limit. In my case, for this example, that comes with pre-filled data, I have 4 and 10. It means I have two values, one for lower spec limits and one for upper specification limit. The Z-shift will be 1.5 by default, and you don't have to change it. And here you see that we estimated the Z-value, the performance Z-value, for process capability calculation, because it's not normal data for before. And here we calculated Z because it's normal data. So depending on normal and non-normal data, we will calculate Z with the formula, or we will estimate Z with probability of observed effects. But we will compare the two, of course. And here you see that we have a Z total value before of 0.17 and after of 6.09, which is very good. And in fact, we don't know if it's long-term or short-term because you have to qualify your data here with long-term. For example, if you consider your data as long-term, meaning you have inside your data both common cause variation and shift or long-term variation, your data are considered long-term, and we can now say that if you compute stats with these specification limits and these defects, it will be long-term value. And to have the short-term value, we will simply add the Z shift value 1.5 to the Z long-term value, and we will find, of course, 1.67 here and 7.59 here because we start from 6.09. So we can say Z is better, so probably you improve a lot your process based on these two samples with 30 data in both samples before and after. And we can statistically speaking confirm that the differences are significant for means, medians, and variances. And here you see you have p-value 0.00, so less than 5%. So the means are, when we test the two means of before and after, significantly different. The medians are significantly different, and the variances are significantly different. So yes, you lower the mean and median value from before and after, and you have less variation, and so you have a better performance and Z value, meaning less defects, less probability of defects after than before. So what you see here graphically is confirmed statistically with the hypothesis tests, which are performed automatically for me. So this is how we can prove an improvement of your why when you have a continuous why. Thank you very much. Bye.